So what we're doing is we're talking about using the pentatonic notes for a blues progression. And the blues progression that we're working with right now is a C minor. It's a 1-4-5, but we're using our C minor as the root. So here's our C minor, right? There's a 1. The 4 for the C, of course, being an F, so we're going to go to F for the 4, and then back to the C minor for the 1, right? Now we could go G or G minor. Let's try G minor for the 5. And then back to maybe a F minor for the 4 again, and then back to the C. Oh, it's cooler with all the minors. So let's do it like that. So we've got our C minor. 1, 2, 3, 4. Playing a C minor and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now shifting down to the F minor. Now back to the C minor. Now we're gonna go to the 5, which is your G minor, back to this F minor, and to the C minor. So that's our basis right there. And if you think about it, it's just basically a 12-bar blues, so I'll count for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4, 9, 2, 3, 4, 10, 2, 3, 4, 11, 2, 3, 4, 12, 2, 3, and then you would go around in a circle. So that's like a whole verse right there of a three chord 12-bar blues. Now, how do we play on top of that in between our strumming? Well, let's do the strumming part first. So the strum might go something like, my other camera's messed up, so hold on. So I'm just going to move the same chords we had before. That is my C minor, right, F minor, and G minor. Those are the only three I'm working with. So the strumming pattern might be something like, bum, 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 and you can make up your own rhythm as much as whatever you want to do. So I'm going to try something like this. Again, that strum, if I slowed it down, would be something like this. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Make it as simple as you want to so that it's rhythmic. And you remember, you got to get 12 bars of that. And they don't all have to be the same either. So you could do one bar like this. The sky is the limit. Once you understand that you have that, Michelle, once you understand that you have that 12-bar kind of, I would call it a framework. I was going to say cage, but it's not a cage. It's a framework. Once you recognize that the shape of that 12-bar framework, the sky's the limit.